In a remote corner of Siberia, a Russian geophysicist named Sergei Zimov and his son Nikita are bringing back the Ice Age. It isn't like they have woolly mammoths and saber-toothed cats running around, although they'd certainly be open to hosting them if anyone ever figured out a solution to that whole extinction thing. Instead, the Zimovs are trying to restore the ecosystem to the way it was 12,000 years ago. Back in the 90s, the Russian government gifted them 160 square kilometers of land to run their massive experiment, which they named Pleistocene Park. And while it's definitely eccentric, the Zimovs' backyard hobby could have huge implications for the fate of the entire planet. Sergei Zimov has dedicated the second half of his career to studying how grazing animals affect grassland habitats. He roped his son into joining the cause, and Nikita is now the director of Pleistocene Park. They're situated in a stark, frozen landscape, about a four-hour flight away from the nearest city. If you lived out here, it wouldn't be hard to imagine the world frozen solid. That's probably how many of us imagined the Earth looked 12,000 years ago at the end of the Pleistocene geological era, better known as the last ice age. But even in Siberia, that's not how it was. Geological records indicate that this shrubby tundra was once covered in lush meadows with grazing megafauna. That kind of ecosystem is called a mammoth steppe. Steppes are dry, grassy plains characterized by low amounts of rain, and mammoth is in the name because of, you know, the mammoths. But since the end of the Ice Age, Siberia has been a scrubby tundra. Tundras are basically cold deserts, and in Siberia, the land is now covered with small shrubs and trees, as well as mosses and lichen. For years, geologists' reigning theory was that higher temperature and humidity at the end of the Ice Age converted the mammoth steppe into a tundra. Without grasses to eat, the megafauna would have been unable to survive. But Sergei challenges this theory. He believes that humans, with their recent invention of long-range weapons, overhunted the steppe's large game, eventually causing the extinction of native grazers. For reasons I'll explain, grasslands disappear without animals to graze and maintain the land. Because the climate in modern northern Siberia is actually very similar to the region's climate at the end of the Ice Age, Sergei is optimistic that the mammoth steppe can be restored. Of course, they can't actually reintroduce mammoths to the steppe, and many other megafauna from the Ice Age are likewise extinct. So in their place, the Zimovs have brought in large grazing animals like reindeer, moose, muskoxen, and bison. But the park isn't a petting zoo just for curiosity or fun. Grasslands could help save a rapidly melting Siberia. Most of Siberia is made of permafrost that ideally remains frozen year-round. But given that the Arctic is warming four times faster than the rest of the planet, that permafrost is in danger. Grasslands reflect more heat from the sun than scrubby tundra, which is important for keeping that permafrost as frosty as possible. Plus, in the winter, the animals have to eat whatever is left over from the growing season. They dig through the snow and eat the old grass, leaving the ground more exposed to the cold air. That means a deeper freeze for the permafrost, so that it won't melt as deeply when the spring rolls back around. The bottom line is that grassland could dramatically reduce the impact of climate change on the Arctic, and grazing animals are the key to the Zimovs' plan to restore it. You might think that animals who eat grass would be the very last thing you'd want when you're trying to grow more grass. Overgrazing by huge livestock herds is definitely a danger and can seriously degrade grazing lands. But reasonable-sized herds of native grazers can actually improve a steppe ecosystem. This happens in a couple ways. First, herds trample the earth, breaking up the tundra's moss and shrubs, clearing space for more delicate grasses to grow. Next, the grazers will quickly eat the scrubby, shrubby bits, which don't grow back very well after losing their leaves. On the other hand, some grasses are quite resistant to grazing and will regrow and spread as the scrub dies. The grasses that survive the grazing do so by diverting nutrients to their root systems. Having their blades ripped off by a browsing bison sends a signal to reinforce and extend the root system, enriching the underground nutrient network and enhancing the amount of carbon drawn into the ground. The final major benefit is the animal's quick digestion of grasses means a fast fertilization cycle. In warmer biomes, bacteria can break down organic matter and return those nutrients to the soil, But in the frosty Arctic, a grazer's gut microbes can do the job way faster than the ground, so that all the good stuff locked up in the plants can return to the ground in just a day or two. So watch your step if you ever take a ramble through these meadows. All these benefits are being tested at Pleistocene Park, but the Zemovs aren't content to let nature progress at its own rate. But before I tell you what they're up to, we need to run a quick ad.
This SciShow video is supported by Incogni, a tool you can use to prevent scams, identity theft, and loss of control over your personal data. This can include information like addresses, political beliefs, property records, and financial data. If you've ever searched for yourself on the internet, you know some of the personal information that's made its way out there. And this problem seems to be growing. So Incogni works to keep your private information private. You can get their protection using the code SciShow at incogni.com/SciShow or clicking the link in the description. That link also gives you 60% off an annual Incogni plan. As part of that plan, Incogni will contact more than 270 data brokers on your behalf to request that they remove your personal data. And they'll keep your data off the market with repeated removals. They also have a new custom removals feature in their unlimited plan that lets you request data removal from almost any website that isn't in the automated process yet. And even with that feature, they offer a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you find that you aren't happy with their service, Incogni will give you a full refund. Incogni helps you stay on the internet so you can keep finding cool stuff like this video. So thank you, Incogni, for supporting this SciShow video.
The owners view the park as a massive geoengineering experiment, so they've manually cleared trees and large shrubs to accelerate the conversion to grasslands. Their herds of large animals have done the rest. Bison knock down small trees and shrubs as they pop up. Musk oxen are uniquely capable of digesting the tough scrub that blankets the tundra and prevents grasses from growing. And where the larger animals have already cleared the scrub, others graze the new grasses. But it's hard to find cold-adapted fauna that can simulate the bygone grazers. They have some native grazers in the park, such as Yakutian horses, yaks, moose, and reindeer. For the rest, they've turned to non-native species, such as American plains bison and Bactrian camels from Mongolia. Because their goal is to recreate the entire Ice Age ecosystem, the Zemovs eventually plan to add predators, like wolves, cougars, and Siberian tigers. And while they aren't in the business of genetic engineering, the park could be a potential home for cave lions or the recently de-extincted dire wolves if those experiments succeed. Above all, they'd love to host a herd of woolly mammoths should they ever be resurrected. Because the role of those furry megafauna would have been to knock down large trees, the Zemovs have cheekily named their tree plowing vehicle Baby Mammoth. So far, the experiment has had positive results. The Zemovs report that in just 20 years, the park has become a lusher and more productive grassland. Visiting journalists have observed that the grass density, coverage, and vitality is much stronger within the park's fences than immediately without. The Zemovs are also constantly measuring the air quality, surface temperature, greenhouse gas levels, and permafrost thaw to conduct quantitative studies on the park. For example, upper layers of the ungrazed soils can be as much as 13 degrees Celsius warmer than grazed soils, and ungrazed soils have been measured to thaw more than 40 centimeters deeper than the grazed soils. One study found that the upper layers of grazed soils held 6 times as much total organic carbon as samples from ungrazed soils. The researchers think that over a longer amount of time, those benefits might extend to lower layers of the soil as well. Of course, Pleistocene Park isn't the only grassland restoration project out there. Programs across North America are bringing bison back to the prairies and plains. Patagonia National Park is adding native grazers with the hope of restoring their grasslands after decades of overgrazing by commercial herds. And steppe ecosystems in Kazakhstan are being restored to hopefully save the native Saiga antelopes. Rewilding is a difficult process, but the importance of animals in shaping and maintaining their landscapes has become clear. Sometimes, they just need a pair of eccentric scientists and a baby mammoth to lead the way.